evening and welcome back to Edenia. My name is Krimiclown and today we're playing some Fallout 4. We're in the Corfega assembly plant and we need to take out some raiders. Well, we're doing fine just now. We're running out of ammo and we have already run out of stim packs. Better safe than sorry, yeah. Absolutely. Alright. Aluminium cans, metal buckets, cigarettes, duct tape, flip lighters, a broom. We'll take it all, but I don't know if we can... Well, we are hidden at the moment, but just like the more that we move, the less hidden we are. There's a scalpel over here. So where do we need to go? Both of our objectives are up somewhere. Oh, we've already been here. We've come full circle. Look at that. So we could go up a floor. Because I think we haven't been here yet. Or have we? This is somewhat familiar. Yeah, this is the entrance. Never mind. So we need to go down then, I guess. We better stay sneaking, because otherwise we're dead meat soon. Very soon. Alright. Let's take a look at this. Dandy boy apples, a coffee pot, some coffee cups. A lot of them, actually. It's another coffee cup. This place is junk heaven. Jeez. Milk bottles, ashtrays, TV trays, dinner trays, beer bottles, nice, cigars. These guys are living it up. Living it up.
Hoarding now?
Yes, I am hoarding now. Yes. I desperately need this oven mitt for sanctuary. I don't know why, but I need it desperately. Some cigarettes. You know what, Cosworth, since you're...
Hey.
Yes, sir?
Let's have a trade. Cosworth, I need you to hold on to all my junk, because I don't like it when you call me a hoarder. Well, you're the one keeping all the junk. There we go. And some more, and some more, and some more. Let's see, what's Cosworth's carry weight? Must be amazing. There we go. Now it's not my fault anymore. There we go. Alright, let's go up. I don't know what's up here, but this plunger is definitely worth it. And a broom. Alright. A flip lighter. Nice. Some more cigarettes. Some cans. Including an aluminium one. The aluminium cans are great. So, have I already been here? This is where the elevator is supposed to come down to. And there's an exit. Also, something else is nearby. Alright, so let's save. There we go. Let's have a look around. I love it how you can just...
The Corfega. I like to think of it as a distant cousin.
Yes, you do. I bet you do. There's a Protectron. I don't know if it's going to be in our aid or if it's going to be our enemy. All right, so let's go slow. Let's go through the shadows. We're still hidden. There's some turrets on the roof, and there's some guy. I think he is our prime target. What was that? Alright. You, this is going to be a stealth headshot. So that one's dead. Right away. Cosworth, what are you doing? We are still hidden, which is good. So, we can have some stealth shots. Like this one. And this one. And this one. Oh, that killed him good. Yes, we are, Cosworth. So there's a turret, but I don't know if I want to hit that turret. Alright, so we're in caution mode.
That won't do. Not at all.
Oh, I picked up something else I didn't really mean to pick up. Alright, so we're in caution mode.
I know you're here.
Yeah, you know I am. But where are you? Oh, there's some raider scum. Oh, that has to hurt. That one's dead. Alright, we're still very low on stim packs. In fact, we've got none. So I suggest we don't do anything weird like blowing up everything. Well, we might want to, though. We've got 6 more revolver bullets. We've got 5 more other bullets, 10mm, and we've got 4 snub-nosed bullets.
I never leave a task unfinished. I'll find you eventually.
Still got some energy cells though. We might want to we might be able to pull this off. So this guy, this
you
raider
call
scum,
this a fight?
He's only inches from
only
death. There we go.
Still alive.
There we go, that one's dead. Right, now we can charge up this one to get rid of the other guy.
Show your face. Come on.
No. How about no? It's Jared. Alright, this guy's named. He's probably very, very dangerous. Oh, he's seen us. And so did the turrets. Alright, so what if we can get this guy? Alright, could we pull off a arm shot? There we go. Oh yes, we can. Alright, another arm shot. Oh, there we go. That's bad. Alright, so we need a way to try and kill him.
Without... Come on.
Yeah, we're going to be safe here. It's going to be some raider still, I guess. Or it's going to be Jared. Alright, let's try the reviver. Let's try the revolver rifle, shall we? Alright, so if we're standing here, the turrets can't
Come
hit
on
us.
Out.
So that's
I'll
good.
Nice and quick.
Alright, so both turrets can't hit me while I'm here. Which is nice. Alright, you. Couple of headshots. And they all miss. Alright, come on. You're not safe to me. Oh, he's in a similar tactic. Fear, he says, yeah. Alright, so we need this guy to bugger off, really. Alright, so we can try a headshot from here. Oh, that is really bad. Alright, let's try that again. So he has he's got a good gun. Very good one, because he can one-shot me. Well, I am very much down on my health. Do I have any aid left at all? Inventory, aid. We've got some Brahmin meat. We've got a lot of stuff, actually. We do have some jet as well. We might want to take some... Well, a squirrel on a stick? Don't mind if I do. And... Ooh, what else? Some fancy lad snack cakes. You know what? We'll have it. At least we're healed up now. That's good. That's good at least. So as long as we're standing here... There's one turret. There's the other
scared,
one.
Huh? You should have hostile lights on.
Oh, that's a misser. Alright. At least we've got a bit of health left now. Alright, show your head. There we go. There we go, that's a headshot. He's dead. Nice. Alright, so this guy's dead. Now we just have to sneak our way through to the turrets. Kill those from close up. You know, Cartsworth, we make quite a good team. Alright, as I said, this is rather hard playing on very hard. Oh shit. That's the worst thing. Oh shit! Oh, that's not good. Well, at least we quick saved after Jared. Jeez. Alright, so we have to try and evade the turrets. Alright. Alright, let's wait for the caution to fade so we can safely move away. But yeah, it is very hard. So this might not be the quickest let's play of Fallout you'll ever see. It's going to be an improvised way of getting past situations. Yeah, I can trust you. I can trust you as far as I can throw you. But yeah, this playthrough of Fallout will not be fast-paced. And if you don't like that, I'm very sorry. But oh yes, we're safe. All right, now how do we? All right, can we press this button? Oh, that's nice. Oh, we nearly made it. We nearly made it. All right, let's try that again. But yeah, this let's play of Fallout is going to be very much improvised combat, and if you like that, that's fine. Because we're going to do a lot of it. Oh, come on, Cosworth. Stop trying to hog all the attention. Alright, we made it. We're nearly dead, but we made it. Oh, there's another turret. Jesus. Tiffany Christ. Alright. We might want to take him out. We might want to take out these guns. So let's try and do that. Alright, so these turrets are... Oh, that's close. We are getting hit. So that's not good. That one's dead. How about that one? Oh shit, there he comes. Shoot him in the head. Oh, that's nice. And a bit disturbing. Wow. Alright. We'll take his rounds. Alright. Cosworth, I'm nearly dead. I'm gonna eat some things, like some ramen meat, and you know what? Some bubble gum, I guess. How about a carrot, or Dandy Boy apples? You know what? And a carrot as well. I think we planted one, right? Yeah, I think we did. All right. How about some? Oh, how about the sweet roll? Nice.
Not even sweating.
Of course I never do.
Ha! Huh. Oh, Godsworth is quite the character. I love it. Alright, so here's this turret. Nearly dead.
Everyone's still alive.
It's gone. So let's grab the SOCOM pistol. Right, so let's press the button. The first thing is this Raider scum. He's got a submachine gun. Well, that's really good. Alright, and this is Jared. He's the big boss. Low-sighted pipe pistol. We might want to take this. A drifter outfit we don't really want. Animal bucket, flip lighter, some scissors. Some mattresses in here. Alright. All sorts of crap. We're getting a bit of rads from standing there. That's not good. It's never good. An extinguisher, we'll take it. Ooh, Nuka-Cola machine. It's a quantum. Nuka-Cola quantum. Nice. So, this is a stool. Where was the other robot? We might get some stuff from him. No? Silver locket. He didn't drop anything. It's a bit of a shame. How about this one? Any drops from you? There we go. Military grade circuit board. And there is still a... still some guys on the floor. We'll just take the battered clipboard and this Grognak the Barbarian. Nice, let's take it. And there's a trunk over here. Tactical calibrated 10mm pistol. That was really good, Cotsworth. I nearly died and you just took a bullet for me. Nice. Let's take a look at our aid, because apparently the Stimpak's not favorited anymore. Put it on zero. So apparently we can't take our last one, because this will unfavorite it. Alright, let's take your nothing. Let's take a look at this gun. Weapons. Where is it? Tactical calibrated 10mm pistol. It does have a sight on it, which is really good. Very good sight. But it doesn't do as much damage as the glow sight at one. And it has a lot more range, this one. So we'll take these instead. Filing cabinets are empty. Oh. Come on, where are you? It's down there somewhere. We're taking a couple of rads. Alright, there it is. Alright. Let's go in hot and heavy. Let's grab the snub nose. We are on the upper hand, it seems. Alright, let's make it a headshot or three or four. Oh, that's not good. Oh, bust the melon. That is amazing. All right. Nothing we really want. There is a lot of radiation stuff going on here. But usually there is a bit of a treasure, but not this time. Alright, so we can scour through this... oh, that's the turret. Yeah, it's gone. There was a terminal up there. We didn't take a look at the terminal, so let's go. I think most people are dead now. Most of the aggressors are dead. Alright, let's take a look. We can use this terminal. There we go. Let's take a seat. Setting up shop. Gun finally quiet down. Alright. Stumped. Oh, we can have spotlight control. We can, can turn it off. It's a bit too late. Now, if there's any more turrets, I will want those turned off as well. Turret control. Deactivate. Right. Now, what else? She's here. Gristle says there's a caravan headed this way, some joker in a cowboy hat with a laser musket, three civilians and one frail old woman. I know it's her. I sent Gristle to collect her. I wonder if she'll recognize me. Alright, so they've got something to do with the Minutemen. Right. All right, this is getting deeper and deeper. Oh, there's a can in this filing cabinet. We'll take the can. All right. Ah, there we go. Now, is this stuff I want to be collecting? No, I don't think it is. I don't think there's anything useful back here. Not like we've checked, but... No, it doesn't look like it. Right, I guess we're out of here then. So, let's see to it that we get out of this place some metal buckets that would come in handy and some vodka. A vodka bottle. Nice. Now, if it's a vodka bottle, does that mean it's empty? Should we take a look? Aid. We don't have any vodka, we just have whiskey, so yeah, it's empty. That's a bit of a shame, really. I was really excited to find some vodka. Huh. Right, keep out. Alright, we missed that sign on the first time, so... excuse us. Alright, we could go out. We could have come in this way, actually. That would have made things a lot simpler. Alright, let's cram. Right outside this this exit, there's some clowns. So let's see if we can't have a little bit of fun. Oh, that's nice. He did a spin of the old... Oh, geez. Caution. Right. You go ahead, Mr. Cotsworth. Could we hit him? No, it's too far away. Oh, we found a lot of ammo for this thing. Oh, take a look at Cotsworth. Jeez. All right, we can hit this guy in the head, apparently. Oh, that must hurt. Oh, look at that. Was that you throwing Molotovs, Cotsworth? That is amazing. All right, let's move out of the way just a little bit. We'll have two headshots, thank you. Alright, come on. Oh, yeah. Alright, so there's a lot of raiders just outside of this building. And luckily we found some ammo, but this is going to be quite the thing. There we go, that's one shot at least. Oh yeah, they start throwing grenades. We're going to be dead. Alright, so let's try to take this silently. Because we need to get out of the way. We're still hidden, so let's use that to our advantage. Cotsworth's going in though. Cotsworth, don't do it. Right, I hope we can fast travel, because that would be great if we could. Let's see. We need to go home, right? No, first we have to go to... Yeah, Ten Pines Bluff. There we go. At least we can fast travel. That's nice. Alright, so we definitely need to sharpen up the guns. So let's hand in this quest, go back to Sanctuary, and choose our perk, because we've leveled up some time ago. And we can take Gun Nut. That's Armorer. This is Gun Nut. There we go. Let's confirm our selection. So now we can make gun mods. Rank 1 gun mods. That's great. We can also do with a bit of Armorer and Rifleman. And also Big Leaks, because we still want to use Melee every now and again. So we've got a lot of perks that we need to go through. Huh. Yeah, we've got a lot of stuff to do. The gunslinger, the pistol one, it's really good, but we'll want to use snipers as well and melee. So yeah, that's a lot of perks we need to get. Stealth and ninja as well as Mr. Sandman and all of the hacker and locksmithing perks. Yeah, we're going to have our work cut out for us. So we are finally here at the Ten Pines Bluff. Now let's hand in this quest. There we go. I'm here, you know.
You find those raiders?
You don't need to worry about them.
I took care of those raiders for you.
No kidding. That's the best piece of news we've had around here for a good long time. So we've been talking. We decided if you came through for us, we'd join up with the Minutemen again. If we want things to get better, we've got to start helping each other. So, we're
absolutely.
In. You can count on us if you need help down the line. Thanks again, friend.
No problem at all. That was really good. All right, so I guess this is also one of our settlements now. I guess we can. Oh, this nice bed. A nice single lonely bed. So can we activate this workshop now? There's Lucas Miller
got
again.
The best armor in these parts.
Yeah, I would love the armor.
Let's see what you got.
Don't cheap out on armor. That's a good way to get yourself killed.
Yeah, that's true, actually. So he's got some champion stuff. Oh, and he's probably got some leather as well. He's not got that much, though. We could sell some stuff. We got a lot of the 38 rounds. But what guns use the 38? That's a good one. You've got apparel and junk and ammo. He hasn't got any weapons. We might want to sell some of these, because apparently we're not using them. So let's sell 240 caps worth of these rounds. There we go. Great. Let's accept. And let's get out of here. We don't need his stuff. So yeah, we can use this this settlement now, which is rather good, actually. We'll not do it for now, but at least we know we can. We can make this into a nice little place. And can we steal their stuff now? Yes, we can. Cosworth, you're not wearing a hat. Some aluminium cans too, that's really nice. Cosworth, why you always got to be so negative when I'm scrounging for stuff? Hell, you're even holding all of my stuff. Alright, let's get back to Sanctuary. And we should report to Preston Garvey, and there's power armor, and there's another quest. We need to bring Jet to the old lady, so she can get stoned out of a melon. Yeah, it's going rather well. It's taking us some time to survive through the very hard difficulty, but at least we're getting somewhere. Alright, now that we're here, let's take a look at the gun mods that we can use. So we've got this glow-sighted heavy 10mm pistol, which is nice because it has a lot of things that we can use already. We can upgrade to hardened, which will up our damage. And we can even upgrade to powerful. We've even got the stuff for it. So let's upgrade to powerful. There we go. Let's make this. And now we're a bit low on adhesive, but we can have a long light barrel, which makes the weight a bit less, which will take our last three adhesive. We might want to use the adhesive on the reflex light, reflex sight, I guess. Yeah, we'll do it like this. And we can't really do the compensator now because we are lacking in stuff. We don't have any adhesive anymore. Adhesive is apparently used in a lot of guns. And let's take a look at the other guns that we're using. The switchblade, we can upgrade it to serrated, but we will need blacksmith. And how about the we could also rename this to the SOCOM. There we go. SOCOM. These guns, we don't really want to give a name. We might want to take a look at what we can modify. This pipe revolver rifle has got a long barrel, which is good enough. And we can also have a stub barrel. Improved hip fire. We can also remove the stock for a standard grip. This just takes a screw and some steel. And it will up the damage even, but it will take away the accuracy. But it will up the damage. Oh, we can do a short scope. Oh, that takes our adhesive. You know what? We'll just do the SOCOM. The SOCOM will be the only gun that we pimp, so to speak. Look at that. That's really nice. So these will be our backup guns. So this one, and this one, and this one. We've got a lot of ammo for this one still, so that's really good. We've got nothing else. Nothing else in the making, at least. We're growing our carrots. I guess that's the carrot. We're growing some melons. Is that the carrot? That's a bit... Yeah, it is. It's the carrot, but it's unassigned. So you know what? We're going to assign Codsworth to doing food again. Oh, come on. I just picked this up accidentally. I didn't really want to. Alright, you know what? Place it there. No, let's not. Not do it in a workshop. Codsworth. You want to work here, right? You want to earn your keep. You know, we'll assign this guy, who is unassigned, to food as well. We need this stuff to be growing. Okay, Sturgis is already assigned. And where's the other one? The Marcy. There she is, doing nothing at all. You can do food as well. So we've got a lot of food now. Alright, let's speak to Mama Murphy. Let's bump her full with Jeb.
I told you sanctuary would grow. The sight never lies.
Hey.
Sure.
That Jeb we talked about, kid.
Here you go.
Here. One hit of Jet.
You did good. Now, let me ride the hide where the sight wants
Codsworth
to take
didn't
me.
Like that.
Diamond City holds answers, but they're locked tight. You ask them what they know, but people's hearts are chained up with fear and suspicion. But you find it. You find that heart that's gonna lead you to your boy. Oh, it's bright. So bright against the dark alleys it walks. That's what you need to do, kid. Follow the signs to the bright heart. Phew. Wow. That took more out of me than usual. I'm gonna need to rest now, kid.
All right, Mama Murphy. You'll have a rest now. I think we should end off this episode by speaking to Preston.
Yeah?
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, you should have one of these flare guns. You can use it to signal for help from any nearby Minutemen. Not much
right.
use yet, but once we have more allied settlements, you'll have help whenever you need it. I don't think I ever told you what happened to the Minutemen. How I ended up as the last one.
No, you didn't. I'm listening.
I'm listening.
Have you heard of the Quincy Massacre?
What was it?
I thought everyone in the Commonwealth knew about that by now. Where the Minutemen betrayed each other and the people they were supposed to protect. I was with Colonel Hollis's group. A mercenary group called the Gunners was attacking Quincy. The people there called for the Minutemen to help.
Right.
We were the only ones that came. The other groups, they just turned their backs on us and the folks in Quincy. Only a few of us got out alive. Colonel Hollis was dead. So I ended up in charge of the survivors. We never found a safe place to settle. One disaster after another. You saw how it ended and conquered.
Don't give up.
As long as you don't give up, the Minutemen will survive.
I'm not about to give up, but I can't protect the Commonwealth all by myself.
Right.
Hell, I could barely protect these people. That's why I'm talking to you. I can't rebuild the Minutemen, but I think you can.
All right. Thanks.
Hey, that means a lot coming from you, Garvey.
I appreciate that. Does that mean you'll do it?
Yes.
Okay. I'll do it.
That's the spirit, sir. And one giant step in the right direction for the Commonwealth.
Good. Good. Welcome aboard. I feel like this is a whole new start for the Minutemen, and the Commonwealth too. Don't worry, I'll be right beside you all the way, General.
That's quite a promotion.
That's quite a promotion you just gave me.
The leader of the Minutemen has always held the rank of General. Our last leader was General Becker. After he died back in 82, nobody could agree on who should take his place.
Right.
But one good thing about being the last Minuteman is, there's no one to argue with me when I say you're the new general. Now it's your job to make it more than an empty title. I've
All
got
right.
something a bit different for you.
Well?
Our scouts have found a promising spot for a new settlement. The trouble is that some kind of vicious beast...
Well, that was really awkward.
Once you clear it out, set up a radio beacon to let settlers know about it. Before you know it, we'll have a thriving new farm instead of wasteland. We'll take back the Commonwealth, one piece at a time.
Right. This Starlight Drive-In, we've been there before, and we can level up again as well. That's great. So, there was a couple of perks that we wanted, like Armorer. Armorer is really good, so we can upgrade our armor to Stealth. Blacksmith, we're just going to be using that for melee weapons, so we don't really want big leagues and blacksmith just yet. We can wait with that. Ninja is really good because it does more damage for sneak attacks. An action boy will regenerate our action points faster. We could do another rank of gunslinger as well, or another rank of sneak. I think we should go for the armor first. So now we've got basic weapon mods, but we can also make basic armor mods. Let's take a look at what we got. So we could do pocketed, and we could also... Oh, we need adhesive for these as well. Oh, we need a lot of adhesive for these. Oh, that's really bad.
What do you need, General?
Preston, we need adhesive, lots of it. So we need vegetable starch, which requires some more corn, and mute fruits. Alright, so let's pick everything our garden has to offer. You know what? We're going to end the episode right here. Oh, lots of potatoes. We're going to end the episode right here. So thank you very much for watching. Next time is probably going to be...
Hey, go check that out. I'm all
ears. Oh, you guys are working hard, I see. Great. Next episode is going to be a base building episode. So we're going to be in and around Sanctuary. We're going to spice up this place. We're going to have some nice things. I don't know what yet, but we'll have some nice things to do. And you know what? We'll give everyone a house and some beds so we can be future-proof. I think that would be rather nice. So let's do it.
Hello, sir.
Hello, sir. We'll do it, but we're going to do it next time. So as I said, thank you very much for watching. Let's place all this shit in the... There we go. Let's place it all. Some potatoes. Nice. And... Ooh. Heavy frame... Oh, we need to store these mods in the... Yeah, we need to store them in the workbench because they're going to pile up very fast. All right, that's going to be it. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Have a great day.